I'm Janelle Green. I'm the Assistant Director of Human Resources for the West Des Moines School District. Today, I'm going to talk to you about the administrative rules on corporal punishment, restraint, and physical confinement and detention. The training requirements are that all school employees, before using physical restraint and physical confinement and detention, shall receive adequate and periodic training, which shall be documented. Periodic training is considered to be annual training, which you need to do every single year. And the way we will document the training, we will use attendance list. The amount of training required depends on the nature of the employee's responsibilities. So employees who work with level 2, level 3 students would receive more extensive training. It is not necessary for all staff to receive this extensive training, but it is required that you receive some training. Chapter 103's purpose is to provide guidance to employees of AEAs, LEAs, and accredited non-public schools. We will discuss limits on physical contact with students. We will discuss force used that is reasonable. We will provide guidance on physical restraint, and we will provide guidance on the use of timeout rooms. However, we would prefer to use the term cool-down rooms. This is not just a special education issue. These rules do apply to all children. Ban on corporal punishment. What is banned? It's an employee of a public school district, accredited, non-public school, or AA, shall not inflict or cause to be inflicted corporal punishment on a student. Define is the intentional physical punishment of a student, including the use of unreasonable or unnecessary physical force or physical contact made with intent to cause harm or cause pain. Adults should intervene at the least intrusive manner possible for a given situation. It is not to be appropriate to put your hands on a child who declined to comply with an order. On the other hand, it would be appropriate to discuss alternatives while a child was climbing out of a second-story window. For example, if a child is harming themselves or harming others, or for the child's safety, yes, you would need to intervene. However, again, you must always remember to use the least intrusive manner possible. What corporal punishment is not? It is not verbal chastisement. Offensive verbal conduct would not violate Chapter 103. IEPs must comply with state standards, including state rules on seclusion and...
Thank you. Thank you.
This was the administrative rules on corporal punishment, restraint, and physical confinement and detention. My name is Janelle Green. Thank you.